bring the action.
Thank you. You don't need to laugh at me. I don't know how to sing, right? Come on, Joy, Sabina. What's your one? I'll try. Anyways, welcome back from that great episode of the program, The Box of Geeks. I really hope you loved it because I was loving it. I mean, I don't know how does Flogson even do that. Flogson, how do you even do that? You know, not keeping everyone in suspense, you know, bringing out everything from the box slowly. Slowly, just small, small, yeah, just bringing it small, small. Anyways, I really hope you enjoyed everything that came out of the box. Tune in again by Thursday for another great episode of the program, The Box of Geeks, with the amazing, beautiful, sexy Flogson. Did you know that today was her birthday? Yay! Today is her birthday, not worse. Today is her birthday. Amo, Flogson, bring the cake and the champagne, because me, I cannot wait to shop later your food. Anyways, so I told her, and I promised you just before we went for the program, The Box of Geeks with Flogson, we were looking at Tuesday Tuesdays, you know, we're actually looking at things we didn't know about Christmas, and we looked at about four of them, right, of five, actually five of them. So we're going to move in over straight to number six of the things we didn't know about Christmas. Well, who sang the song we're listening to? Jingle Bells Rock. Yes, you know there is Jingle Bell and then there is Jingle Bell Rock. Alright, so Jingle Bells Rock is by, is a song originally sung by Bobby Helms. Yes, Bobby Helms. There are lots of covers for that song right now, but the original singer is Bobby Helms, and that song is really, 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 really a classic. Okay, so Jingle Bell Rocks. I'm rocking the Christmas. Who's rocking the pre-Christmas celebrations for me already? Yep. We get it. We're bringing the action. Yeah, we're bringing the action. All right, this is your number one online radio, which is solely here for your listening pleasure. And all of me remains the ever energetic, ever, ever pretty, you know, radio host, Vicky Lonia. Yeah, I'm pretty. You need to see me. Find me on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, Vicky Lonia. Want to find me? Say I'm pretty, Joe. Alright, so without wasting much time, number six of what we didn't know about Christmas. Are you ready for me to go ahead and bring the action on that one? Ready! Yeah, I know you are ready. Okay, so number six. Now, I was the last one I talked about Saint Nicholas in number five, right? Where I said Saint Nicholas is a patron saint, okay? And for those of us who are Catholic, he's a patron saint. All right, he's a patron saint of unmarried women, prisoners, thieves, and pawnbrokers. You know, he's a patron saint of this kind of people. He prays for them. He brings them into the household of God. You know, tries to change them, tries to make them, you know, help make them repent of their sins, you know, and face God. Okay, so he is a giver. Yes, he is a giver, a generous giver, a very rich saint who decided to donate all his belongings to the poor. Okay, so like I told us in number five, the origin of having to hang stockings, you know, overnight and expect magic to happen. So that was actually real in those days, okay, in the days of Saint Nicholas. Okay, he was, you know, what children did, they would hang out their stockings, and then Saint Nicholas, when he's going around at night, he's like he was like the Santa Claus, okay? He would go around and then he would fill up the stockings with gold, money, sweets, and all that. All right, so who actually is Saint Nicholas, like I said, okay? So, well, let us talk about Saint Nicholas. That is tip number six. So, Saint Nicholas is actually the patron saint of unmarried women, prisoners, thieves, and pawnbrokers. Okay, sure, you probably know that Santa Claus came from Saint Nicholas. He, like I told you, he is one who brought about Santa Claus. Okay, like he started it first. He was a very, very first person. He happens to be a Christian bishop living in the who lived in the fourth century, that is after the death of Christ. So Saint Nicholas gave away his abundant inheritance to help the needy. He also was known for good deeds like rescuing sisters from prostitutions, you know, and all that, rescuing, you know, trying to help armed robbers, thieves to repent, prisoners from jail, and all that. So he was also known for good deeds like that. And his legend spread because he was eventually known by lots of names. Number one of them includes Sinterklaas, which happens to be the douche version of Santa Claus. Okay, so he is not just the protector of children, he is actually a patron saint of unmarried women, prisoners, thieves, and pawnbrokers. So he was the very first Santa Claus who goes around that night, you know, Christmas Eve, you know, dropping sweets into the stockings of children, you know, dropping money and other gift items. So he is the very, very first Santa Claus ever. Alright, did you know that? Well, now you know, because it is Tuesday Tipsies right here on yours truly, solely for your listening pleasure, Vicky Love New Radio. Alright, now, tip number seven, Rudolph. We all know Rudolph, right? Yeah, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, yeah. We're off the red-nosed reindeer, had a very shiny nose. Yes, that Rudolph. Now, here is one thing you need to know about Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. So, a copyright named Robert L. May, okay, first invented the oddball reindeer. That was in 1939 as a marketing gimmick for Montgomery Ward's holiday coloring books, okay? So, May considered naming the beloved Rudolph that we know today. Rudolph would have been named Reginald. Reginald the Blue-Nosed Reindeer, because it was going to give, you know, Rudolph red nose. Okay, Rudolph was a character that was used for advertisement and promotion by a man named Robert. Okay, he published drawing books for kids. Okay, so in order to make it more attractive for kids, he created the character Rudolph, okay, and gave him a red nose. Now, before that, he was going to name him Reginald. And then he was going to give him a blue nose. So just imagine we are singing Reginald the Blue Nose Reindeer. That would have been so odd, like so off. Anyways, he was going to give him a blue nose. But at the end of the day, he just decided to give him red. And he was going to name him Reginald. And then later, he decided to just name him Rudolph. And that's why today we are singing Rudolph the Red Nose Reindeer. It would have been Reginald the Blue Nose Reindeer. All right, though, let us continue. All right, the next one here, number seven, Jingle Bells. This song, Jingle Bells, Jingle Bells. Okay, no, Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Yes, that kind, that particular Jingle Bells was actually a Thanksgiving church song. It was a Thanksgiving song in church. Okay, so there is this man named James Lord Pierpont, okay, who happens to be an organist from Savannah, Georgia, who first performed a song he wrote. He titled "The One Horse Open Sleigh." Okay, but somehow during Christmas it was changed to Jingle Bells. So before, the song was named "The One Horse Open Sleigh." You know, it was a church song, a song sang in church, not during Christmas. But, you know, as the Christmas celebrations evolved, the song was renamed Jingle Bells. And now we no longer sing the song in church on ordinary days. We now sing it only for Christmas days. All right. Now, the next tip is that, did you know that about 15,000 people are always rushed to the emergency room every Christmas? Yes, because preparations for Christmas are always dangerous and hazardous, okay? Like, you know, having to climb the Christmas, you know, there are some people who really have these tall, long Christmas trees, you know, have to climb the Christmas trees, you know, to hang the gifts. You have to climb fence to hang the Christmas lights. You have to, you know, connect it to the socket and all that. You know, a lot of people go through, some people fall from the ladder, some people get electrocuted and a lot of things. About 15,000 people every year are rushed. Every Christmas, I rush to the hospital, I rush to the emergency room because of one Christmas decoration hazard or the other. So be careful this Christmas. Don't go and get electrocuted, please. I want to chop your chicken. Let me know here you're in the hospital. I beg you. All right, the next tip here is, you should know that Santa Claus has his own zip code. Everybody that say, I have a zip code, scan my zip code, scan my QR code, scan my barcode. Santa Claus has his own zip code. Did you know that? No, you didn't know. Now I'm telling you. He has his own zip code. And what is his zip code? Ho, ho, ho. So in those days when children, you know, there are lots of letters used to always, lots of kids always send letters to Santa Claus, you know, through the mailbox, okay? So, you know, the people working in the mail office, in the post office, were like, so many letters. We can't read all of them. So what they did was that in order for you to be able to post a letter, you have to scan the zip code. You have to know the zip code. So it's a secret zip code, and only people knew it. And what was that zip code? Ho, ho, ho. That is why you hear lots of people say, oh, Father Christmas, ho, ho, ho. That is so amazing. Ho, ho, ho. So, I know the zip code. Now you know the zip code. Hey, start writing your letters already. All right. It is still Tuesday Tipsies right here at Vicolonia Radio. And it's really, really, really fun because I'm loving it. I don't know about you, but I'm loving it. Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. Jingle bell. All right, okay, so moving off to the last tips we'll have here, just a couple more, okay. All right, the last one I have here is about this one called Xmas. So a lot of us are wondering, Christmas, Xmas, what's the difference? Are they trying to remove the Christ from Christmas? No, they're not trying to do that. Do you know that in Greek, the letter X or the letter CHI actually means Christ, okay? So in the Greek country, okay, in Greek, what they do is that instead of writing Christmas like Christmas, they're like, let's just abbreviate it to X. X actually means Christ in Greek, okay? So you can say Christmas, you can say Xmas. There's no difference. They are both the same thing. So don't go say, oh my God, they're trying to take away Christ, and that means they're using X to cross Christ. They're taking Christ away from Christmas. They're not doing that, so please. All right. Okay, and then the last one here is the mistletoe. Now, the mistletoe, you know the mistletoe on for Christmas trees, the mistletoe. Do you know that mistletoe was believed to be a sex aphrodisiac? Okay, when you kiss someone under the mistletoe back in those days, when you kiss someone, it means that you're ready to have sex with the person, or you are available to have sex. Yes, because it is actually, the mistletoe is a symbol, is a Druid symbol for fertility and virility. Okay, it actually believed that when you kiss someone under the mistletoe, it means that the both of you are literally going to be having sex, like banging it hot. Am I supposed to be saying that? Nah. Okay, anyways, that's not how it is now. another, still a kiss under the Christmas tree, miss it all, no problem, enjoy it. Alright, that's all I've got for you, and that officially brings us to the end of the program. Tuesday Tips says, till I come away again, I come your way again with this program next Tuesday. I love you.